Mr. Speaker, tonight I will have the privilege of hearing the State of the Union address that I have been waiting to hear since I first came to Congress 7 years ago. Tonight, our entire country will hear a confident message of undeniable good news for all Americans, not based on fantasy and hope, but on facts and undeniable success. Tonight, the President of the United States will come to the people's house and speak to a nation that is far better off today than we were just 1 year ago in every measurable way. Now, this success did not come by accident. Over the past year, by working with a unified Congress, President Trump was able to begin implementing his agenda to make America great again. Let's revisit what he's done. When it comes to accomplishments, the signing of the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act marked the first time our tax code was updated in over 31 years. It lowered tax rates for all taxpayers across the board. It cut the corporate tax rate from 35% to 1%, or 21%, which allows us to compete globally. It permanently repealed Obamacare's individual mandate. It opened up ANWR for drilling and brand new energy exploration. When it comes to deregulation, we signed 15 CRA bills into law in less than a year, imposed a groundbreaking rule on federal bureaucracy to kill two regulations for every new regulation written, and has rolled back more job-killing red tape than every president before him combined. When it comes to the courts, by appointing conservatives like Neil Gorsuch to the Supreme Court in an historic number to the appellate courts, he is restoring constitutionalism and common sense to our judiciary system. These appointments will reverberate for generations to come. Now, when it comes to the outcomes, the entire stock market is at an all-time high. And contrary to what some people will speak, this affects the pensions of all Americans. Federal unemployment, it is its lowest level since 2001. Black and Hispanic unemployment are at their lowest levels ever. For 13 different states, overall unemployment is at its lowest rate since we first began recording it. New manufacturing orders are increasing at their fastest pace in 14 years. Quarterly GDP is exceeding expectation and is on track for a 3% annual growth rate for the first time in 13 years. Consumer confidence is at its highest level since 2000. Job market confidence is at its highest level ever. And because of the Tax Cuts and Jobs Bill alone, more than 3 million American workers and counting are receiving $1,000 bonuses or more, and wage increases and or benefit increases. Now, in my own city that I live in, NextTier Bank gave over 250 of its associates a $1,000 bonus. Those are hardly crumbs when it comes to hardworking American taxpayers. Abroad, the Islamic State, once thought to be unstoppable, is now shattered. Military morale, recently at rock bottom, is now soaring. Our troops are currently receiving their largest pay raise in 8 years. When it comes to liberty and conscience issues, we've ended the war on religious liberty. They tore up the so-called HHS contraceptive mandate. No more nuns fighting for their survival in the Supreme Court. And reinstated the Mexico City policy the first weekend in office. When it comes to energy, we ended the war on coal. We stopped the EPA's so-called clean power plan. We approved both the Keystone XL and Dakota pipelines and put plans in place to dramatically expand offshore drilling. When it comes to American leadership, we pulled out of the Paris Climate Accord. We ended the Cuban appeasement. We condemned and decertified the Iran deal. Guantanamo Bay is still open with no threat of closing. By changing the rules of engagement, by trusting our generals and unleashing our military might, he has overseen the total destruction of the ISIS caliphate. The entire world is safer because of American leadership. Through his words and deeds, most recently with Jerusalem, the world sees America leading with moral clarity and confidence again. Mr. Speaker, tonight I will have the privilege of hearing the State of the Union that I have been waiting to hear for 7 years. Tonight, we will look at an economy and a State of the Union that is as strong as Pittsburgh Steel. Our economy is roaring, and America's optimism is soaring. Our citizens are becoming more prosperous. Our law enforcement is becoming empowered and not undermined. Our military is growing stronger by the day. Our international credibility is being restored. Our friends once again trust us. Our enemies once again fear us. The whole world knows that we will always put America first. But this is just the start. There is still much work left to be done, but as of today, the facts say it all. America is winning again. And I yield back.